Hello friends, we are back with our studies continuation. In the last lecture we had studied what is bioremediation. In that we had studied the isolation, purification. We had studied isolation, purification, identification, optimization, determination, identification, cell and enzyme identification. So we will move today our next point, that is enzyme identification, that is called as cells and enzyme immobilization. Means some enzymes are also being used for the degradation, for the bioremediation process. Enzymes play a very vital role in case of the degradation process or remediation process. So in enzyme immobilization, they are defined as the enzymes that physically or chemically confined in a defined material with retention of its catalytic activity. Means when that particular enzymes acts with their specific substrate, they are physically or chemically confined with defined materials and its activity is to be done. In that immobilization methods, there are three methods: carrier binding method, cross linking method and entrapping method. In carrier binding method, covalent binding methods, ionic bonding methods, physical adsorption and biospecific binding methods. And in the third, entrapping methods, there is a lattice method, microcapsule method, membrane method and reserved micelle method. So these methods are being used. The entrapment method means the enzymes are being entrapped in the substrate, or where or which particular component we have to remediate, we have to detoxify. Again, the detoxification is also the part of bioremediation. So that is art been done with the help of entrapping methods. So for in the first carrier binding methods, what are the materials that we can use for the material binding methods? In that, polysaccharides, proteins, synthetic polymers and inorganic materials are being used. So that materials, in case of carbohydrates, polysaccharides, they are cellulose, dextran, agarose derivatives, etc. In case of protein, gelatin and albumin, the bovine serum albumin that you can use. In the three, synthetic polymers, polystyrene derivatives, ion exchange resins and polyurethane. Inorganic materials, glass, sand, ceramic and magnesium. So these components or the materials are being used for the binding methods. And in the entrapping methods, there are two types, lattice method and microcapsule method. In the lattice method, polyacrylamide gel that you can use, calcium alginate and PVP, that is polyvinyl alcohols, polymers or polyvinyl pyrrolidones that you can use for the entrapment. For the entrapment method means the specific component we have to entrap, and after the entrapation or after the entrapping procedures, the degradation will be there. So for that process, for the entrapment of that particular component, that particular molecule, we have to use this type of components or the materials in case of lattice type. And in microcapsule type, you can use interfacial polymerization method, liquid drying method. There are two methods in the microcapsule method: interfacial polymerization method and liquid drying method. In image you can see their entrapment in a matrix and entrapped in a droplets. See here, in case of two entrapment methods, in case of enzyme activity or the factors are been what factors are been responsible to entrapment, so entrapment is essential. So in the matrix, the entrapment in may be matrix or in the droplets. See here, then absorption process, means that particular enzyme is attaches to the walls of that particular medium or the material with the absorption method. Then that particular enzyme attaches with that particular material or the component by covalent bonding, by cross-linking, and by non-covalent entrapment method. So these are the steps are been there for the entrapment of the enzyme to its substrate or to its material. Then phytoremediation, the major point or the main concept of the bioremediation, that is phytoremediation. Phytoremediation is nothing but it is the use of plant for accumulation, for degradation, for removal, or for conversion of pollutants. Use of plant or use of plant parts. In the phytoremediation, there are five processes: phytostabilization, phytotransformation, phytovolatilization, phytoextraction, and phytostimulation. So these are the five major steps that are being took place in the phytoremediation: phytostabilization, phytotransformation, phytovolatilization, and phytoextraction and phytostimulation. See, the phytodegradation, phytovolatilization, phytoextractions means from the plant constituents, the extractions, the pollutants are being extracted. Stabilization means they are stabilized in the soil molecule, stimulates in case of soil pollutants, and phytodegradation, phytovolatilization, and phytoextraction, these are in case of the air pollutants. So in case of air pollutants, three methods are being used: phytodegradation, phytovolatilization, and phytoextraction. And in case of soil pollutants, to degrade the soil pollutants, this must be phytostabilization and phytostimulation. Approximately 400 plant species are being used as accumulators of heavy metals or hyper accumulators of heavy metals. That heavy metals accumulated plants are grasses, sunflower, corn, hemp, alfalfa, tobacco, mustard, water hyacinth. In case of the Icornia is the best example as of water hyacinth. It accumulates the pollutants in the water bodies of the polluted water bodies. Then afterwards, the root extractions or root exudates play an important role in phytoremediation as it activates the surrounded microbe. Why? Because root exudates are why so much effective in case of the remedy by phytoremediation, because they almost or they always surrounded with the microorganisms that are been present inside the soil. So the components that are been present in the root extracts or in the root exudates, they are being helpful. They have capability and they are daily, day-to-day life, they are fighting with the microorganisms. So for that reason, that particular root extracts are being essential for the phytoremediation process, or they play an important role in the phytoremediation. Genetic engineering are also used in case of BT protein. Pheromones, the flower producing hormones, these are called pheromones. They are produced by the shoot leaf cells or the leaf part. They are been responsible to degrade the pollutant. Next, the bioremediation of metals contaminated environment. So these are the metals contaminated environment. Metals bioremediation mechanism means metals we have to bioremediate that are been harmful to the fauna that has been present in the water bodies, hana. So that heavy metals are been very much effective or harmful for the living organism in the water bodies like pond, hana. So that metal bioremediation is also been essential. So in the metal bioremediation, there are two processes: metal immobilization and solubilization. Means there is immobility of the metals has been completely removed, that is called by two methods. Metal immobilization is done by two methods, complexations and precipitations. Complexations, it is bioaccumulation, biospersion process. The accumulation of the causing harmful component from the metals or the heavy metals that are been removed. So that is called as by exopolysaccharide and by lipoproteins. And in case of precipitation, the H2S producing bacteria, siderophores and metal reductions are being used. And in second technique of metal bioremediation mechanism is that is bioleaching, and it is done with the biosolubilization process. It is due to the organic acid, siderophores and root exudates. See here, the root exudates are also playing in the role of for the degradation of the heavy metals. In case of contaminants potentially amenable to bioremediation means readily biodegradable, somewhat degradable, difficult to degrade, and the components that are been amenable means they are have ability to degrade or bioremediate. In that four categories are been there: readily biodegradable, somewhat biodegradable, difficult to degrade, and generally recalcitrant, means they consist in the calcium as a major part. So fuel, gasolines, ketones and alcohols, monocyclic aromatics and biocyclic aromatics are been readily biodegradable. But in case of somewhat degradable, the cerastol, coal tars and the pentachlorophenol. And in case of difficult to degrade, that is chlorinated solvents and some pesticides and herbicides, like the 2,4-D, these are the pesticides that are been generally used by the farmers. They are difficult to degrade. But nowadays, some bacteria like Pseudomonas are been responsible to degrade such type of pesticides also. In case of fungi, they are also been responsible to degrade the fungicides, pesticides. Generally, recalcitrant, diloxins and PCBs, polychlorinated biophenols, are been generally recalcitrant. So in case of shortly, we have to study that some components are been easily degradable and some components they are tough to degrade, but they can degrade, but they are tough procedure to that. So this is all about the biodegradation process. Hope the students will understand this point. The previous lecture and this lecture is about biodegradation. So tomorrow we will be there again, a new topic for in case of the botany students especially. Thank you very much.